Good morning, and welcome to another video of mine, Michelle Fortier. I'm a licensed clinical social worker in the state of Florida, and today's video is going to be another DBT skill. And this one is my favorite DBT skill, my absolute favorite. This one is the radical acceptance skill that is under the distress tolerance. So radical acceptance, what is it? Well, in DBT, what we mean by radical acceptance is that we accept our situation as it is. What that means is that there is no should, it shouldn't be this way, it should be this way, it's not fair, it's not right, blah, 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 blah. In radical acceptance, we accept the situation as it is. There's no more bucking the reality, there's no more pretending that the reality doesn't exist. We are clear in understanding that this reality is due to a bunch of different factors, and based on those factors, this is the way that it played out. And so with this acceptance of reality, we can actually change this reality. We can actually work on problem solving this reality, because it's not until we go ahead and we accept the situation as it is that we can move forward from that situation. Because otherwise we're spending all our time sitting there bucking the situation instead of working through the situation. So what is it that needs to be accepted? What needs to be accepted, I'm going to refer to my handy dandy little book. And if you do not have this book, you should totally get it if you are interested in doing DBT. And it is the DBT Skills Training Manual by Marshall Linehan, who is the creator of DBT. So there is the acceptance that everything has a cause. We might not have been the cause. We might not have been the reason that our situation exists, but this does not preclude us from solving the situation that is at hand and accepting the situation as it is on hand. Now, why should we accept reality as it is? Because rejecting it does not change it. Sticking our head in the sand and pretending that our reality exists does not change that reality. There's also that the pain of the reality can't be avoided. We have to deal with that pain. Trying to push away pain, trying to pretend that pain doesn't exist, all of this does nothing to get rid of the pain. Anybody that has been through painful situations, and I'm pretty sure every single person under the sun has been through painful situations, knows that simply trying to push away the pain just means that it's going to pop up at times and in places and in circumstances that we really don't need it to, that we have to have clarity of mind and clarity of emotional experience in order to contend with things. But if we continue to push away reality and not accept that reality, we then have to contend with these feelings popping up. Refusing to accept reality, it leaves us in bitterness, it leaves us in anger, it leaves us in frustration. My favorite thing to say, and some people get annoyed by this, but you know, it's my saying, it is what it is. Until we can accept what is, we cannot work to change what is. And I love this saying. This is what good old Marsha says. The path out of hell, the path out of our suffering is to go through our suffering, to push our way through, to accept it, to move forward from it, is the only way out of it. So what is not acceptance of reality? Acceptance of reality does not mean that we condone or agree with that reality. It does not mean that we like that reality or that we don't want to change that reality. Acceptance of reality just means that we acknowledge and accept the facts of the situation, that we don't try to move those facts or buck those facts or pretend like those facts don't exist. It does not mean that we like those facts, that we accept that this is the situation and we are not going to change it. That is not acceptance of reality. It is not approval of that reality. It is not, an instance, an example is there, some people don't want to deal with the fact that their loved one has a substance abuse problem. And all they're doing when they're not acknowledging and accepting that reality is not addressing that reality. When we accept that our loved one has a substance abuse issue, we can make choices about that, how we want to handle it. What we are not doing is saying, oh, I approve of your substance abuse problem. I approve of your behaviors. I like your behaviors. I don't want you to change your behaviors. That is not acceptance of reality. When we accept that our loved one has a substance abuse problem, we can actually put things in place that can help push that person to change, that we can actually have that person, they themselves, be able to understand that this is their issue and there's something that needs to change about it. So what makes it that we don't want to accept reality? Well, we sometimes don't want to have to make those decisions. If we finally accept that our loved one has a substance abuse issue, then we have to go and we have to make decisions about how we want to handle that issue. Which sucks. It absolutely sucks. So some people would rather not accept that this is the way that it is because they don't want to have to make tough choices. There is also a belief that if you accept the event or you accept the reality, that you are going to be stuck with that reality. And so people don't want to accept that reality because they don't want to be stuck with it. There's also sometimes people don't know how to accept reality. And then there's also sometimes emotions get in the way of accepting that reality. We have overwhelming anger about that reality, and we don't know how to let that anger go. We don't know how to work through it. So we rather just sit there and be stuck with that reality and bucking that reality and pretending like that reality doesn't exist. So now what are the skills? What are the step-by-step skills in order to practice radical acceptance? The first thing that we need to do is acknowledge, using our mindfulness skills, an acceptance that this is the reality and that you are fighting against that reality. Anytime we use the word should, we're probably not accepting that reality. It should be this way. They should do it this way. It's the way that they're doing it shouldn't be this way. Whenever we go and we say that stuff, what we're doing is we're imposing what we want the world to be like instead of accepting the way that the world is. The next thing is reminding yourself that this unpleasant reality, if we do not accept it, we are unable to change it. The next thing, the next step, is to remind ourselves that based on the circumstances, based on the way the events played out, this was the outcome. This is it. There's an acknowledgement that some sort of history led to this moment, that there are lots of different factors that push things into play. When we're able to accept that this is the way that it was going to play out based on all these factors, it makes it much easier to accept that reality. The next step is to practice acceptance with every part of you. There is where you accept it with your heart, your soul, your body, your mind, your emotions. Use accepting self-talk. Say to yourself, well, this is the way that it was going to be. These are the circumstances that led up to it. These are the things that I know played a factor in it, and accept that reality with every part of you. The next thing to do is practice opposite action. And opposite action is a skill where your feelings push you to do a behavior, like depression pushes you to stay in bed, and that might not be effective. It might not be effective to dealing with reality, to duck out and not deal with things. And so when we say that we're practicing opposite action, what we're doing is we're doing the opposite of what our emotion is pushing us to do in order to change our emotion. I will do a video at some point detailing opposite action, so that way people can have a greater understanding of what that looks like and how to do it. Then there's the skill of cope ahead that we can use. So this is where we anticipate that certain situations are going to play out based on that reality, and we learn to cope ahead with that. So this is something when we're talking about the substance abuse, that we know that we're going to have to contend with that family member. And we talk about and we figure out how we are going to cope with those strong feelings that come up when we have to deal with that family member. This isn't a form of projecting into the future. What we are doing is we are saying, well, you know I have to go to this party with, you know, my, my dad or my mom. And I know that she's going to be high because that's her past behavior. And I know that she has this issue. What am I going to do and how am I going to cope with those strong feelings that are elicited? There is no projection like, oh my God, I can't handle this. When we do cope ahead, what we're saying is we can handle this. We are going to put the skills that we need in play. We're going to keep them in our back pocket. And when the situation presents, we're going to know how to cope with it. And when we're doing the cope ahead skill, what we're doing is we're practicing before we go into that situation. So that way we know what our go-to is going to be when we have to deal with that issue. The next step is that we are going to be able to understand what our situation is going to be doing within our body. So this allows us to have an understanding that our emotions physically impact us. And we're going to put things in place that allow us to be mindful of our emotions, mindful of our physical sensations that come about from those emotions. And we're going to know how to tolerate those strong emotions and those strong physical feelings that are tied to those emotions. The next step is to accept that these situations can sometimes bring up strong feelings of grief and sadness and be able to deal with those feelings of sadness and grief. Accept that this situation is sad, that this situation hurts your heart. And then once you accept that those feelings exist, then you can work through them. The next step is to acknowledge that even though there is pain in life, there's also joy. That this situation will be worked through. That there is an end to any painful situation. That we're going to know how to cope with it. And the next and the last one is to do a pros and cons list of what the pros are of accepting reality and what the cons are. And generally, those pros of reality acceptance generally outweigh the cons. And then being able to look at that list and be able to deal with that list. So that is radical acceptance. And when you are having a difficult time with that, there is where it's called turning the mind. Every single time you start bucking that reality, what you do is you go ahead and you turn your mind back to that acceptance of reality. You don't keep fighting that reality. You say, this is the way that it is, and you go through your steps again and again and again until you finally can accept that reality. So I hope this was helpful. I hope that I explained it well enough. If you have any questions or any concerns, please go ahead and leave them in the comment section. I do try to answer them as quickly as possible. Also, if you like this, please like, subscribe, and share. And I wish you good mental health and continued freedom. Take care.